It's going to be a big weekend here in Brisbane. London is right now preparing for the coronation of King Charles III, an historic event, 70 years in the making.
For more, we're joined by royal editor of the Daily Mirror, Russel Myers, in London. There he is. Russell, still no sign of Harry. When's he expected to arrive?
Well, that's a big question. Good morning both to you. I don't know at the moment. We're still watching and waiting for him to turn up. But certainly I do think it is going to be a very, very quick trip for Harry, because obviously we've had the fallout from his Netflix series, the book which nobody was spared from his barbs. And I think it will be pretty uncomfortable for him to be around the family, to put it mildly. But I think, you know, he might be arriving tomorrow and then pretty much hot-footing out straight away.
Do you know, there's been all sorts of stories circulating that, you know, I think probably from inside the palace, that he's been a nightmare to deal with, trying to coordinate it all. There have been so many of them, you half think it's true.
Well, I'm not sure what would give you that impression of him, Carl. I'm sure he's very, very mild-mannered and easy to deal with. But certainly, I think that there were a few headaches, let's put it that way, dealing with Harry. And, you know, people in the palace are most likely breathing a huge sigh of relief that Meghan isn't accompanying him, because it means it will be a quick trip. The fact that Meghan's staying behind with the kids, it's Archie's birthday, of course, or his fourth birthday, on the same day as the King's coronation. And that's why Harry will definitely want to be getting back, because, you know, it wasn't a very, very nice experience for him when he was here for the Queen's funeral. So, you know, there still needs to be a bit of patching up with the relationships.
So probably unlikely that they'll ask for him to sign their copy of Spare, you reckon?
Well, I'm sure they've all read it. I mean, I don't believe them for a second that they've said that they haven't read it. I mean, we all have, haven't we? And it's been it was a great read. And even if he was speaking about his frozen private parts, it gave us much to laugh about.
Look, it's a big day for Camilla as well. Yeah. And the King, you know, the King's waited a long, 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 long time for this day.
He has indeed. I mean, Princess Anne did an interview this week, and she said, we know exactly what we're getting, because he's been waiting to do the job an awful long time. And, you know, regardless of your affiliation with the royals or whether you think that this is a good idea, it will be the best of British on the show. I cannot wait to see all the armed forces out there. It's going to be a fantastic ceremonial event. And I think that the King has a good heart, and for him, you know, to have a welcome like this for the nation, I think I'm looking forward to it.
I can't wait to see him. I just can't wait to see Louis and how Louis just mixes things up.
He's also step up.
You know, and Prince George has a special role as well.
He does. I mean, we've seen, you know, a few of the royals out and about over the last couple of days, a big last rehearsal at Westminster Abbey. We saw Kate and William in London pulling some pints, meeting the locals, and they were talking about George. He's going to be one of the pages of honour for the King, and a big, big role for him. And, you know, this is a chance of a new era for the family. We've had a lot of scandal, infighting over the past few years, so maybe a new leaf, who knows?
Yeah, we'll never know exactly. All right, well, thanks so much for your time, Russel. And Nine's special coverage of the coronation of King Charles III begins tomorrow with an extended edition of Weekend Today from 6 a.m.
Enjoy it all, Rusty. Thank you. Still
days out from the King's coronation as we go to air, and the finishing touches are being made. Celebrations have already begun in England, with the royals out in full force, attending meetings, greeting fans, a lot of handshaking.
The Waleses are busy, aren't they? Oh. For more, Associate Editor of the Daily Telegraph, Camilla Tominey, The Telegraph, joins us live from Manchester. Camilla, thank you so much for joining us. How's it all looking? How are the finishing touches coming along?
Well, there's a bit more bunting being unfurled, I've noticed, as I've been travelling around London today. Crowds beginning to gather. There are some people already camping overnight just outside the palace there, as you see it, for a coveted glimpse of the royals on the balcony come Saturday. Weather's not looking too great, so look at them there. They're all kind of covered up and trying to keep warm and dry. That's typical for Britain, isn't it? You can't make it up on a May bank holiday, but there you have it. Yeah. And as you say, there's been some royal action today with William and Kate out at the pub, would you believe, guys?
So, I mean, they kind of shocked onlookers by making this almost like a surprise pub visit. Maybe they were just thirsty, but how were they received?
I love the fact that they chose to go to the Dog and Duck. You couldn't get a more quintessentially British pub name, yes. Should you? They were received very well. You could see them there petting pet dogs that had been brought along by the crowds. At one point, William even poured a pint. Now, having worked in a pub, I've got to confess, it wasn't the best pint pouring I've ever seen.
There you go,
quite
that's
stony.
Good.
Not enough head, too much head.
Well, it's far too much head. The whole cup was head. Look, and it's being poured from the Kingmaker Ale, aptly named there. Kate didn't have a go, and in fact, they were both presented with pints. And what I found quite funny is William kept on sipping his. Kate took hers there, as you can see, but I don't think she touched it. Mm. Maybe she's more of a Chardonnay or indeed a gin and tonic woman.
She might be a bit of a shandy girl.
I think she's a shandy girl.
A bit of a shandy girl.
She's got shandy vibe.
So she looked
it.
Like Kate was really embarrassed by the head on that beer.
Really embarrassed, yeah. The one they gave her was pretty shocking, too. Anyway, they need some tips. The Prince of Wales, William, sat down with our Prime Minister Anthony Albanese, our PM offering him a very Aussie gift.
Yes, some Lamingtons. This is a big Aussie thing, I take it, from Bondi, I believe. So a little taste of home. He's in a little bit of a dilemma, though, isn't he, the Prime Minister? Because I think there's the appetite among Aussies to have William and Kate visit. Mm. He's not extended an invitation to the King yet, although protocol would suggest that the King should go before the Prince and Princess of Wales. I think Australia is well overdue a royal visit. It just depends which one nabs the place first.
Well, I believe he did extend an invitation to the King when they met a couple of days ago, but the King expressed some concerns over whether or not he would be welcome given the Republican push that is happening, you know, from our own Prime Minister, essentially, which is interesting. But we'll take them all. We enjoy
it. They can come visit any time. It's open door policy here.
Open door. Speaking of Aussies, there seems to be a lot of them over there right now. Are you running into them all over the shop? We really make our presence felt in faraway places, Camilla.
We are always running into Aussies. I mean, I like to go to West London to find all the Aussies in Ealing and Earl's Court and that area. Of course, they're now gravitating both towards Windsor Abbey, Westminster Abbey and the Palace in order to try and get a glimpse. I mean, you've got to kind of pick and choose your spot because people have to now be planted there until Saturday with the hope that when the police move the crowds forwards from the Mall, that they'll be outside the Palace gates where they obviously get to see not only the brawls on the balcony, but also the flypast overhead, which, fingers crossed, guys, we hope will still take place. Been a bit of concern about it because of the weather. It's meant to be 6 minutes long, featuring all of these RAF aircraft and Spitfires and more modern aircraft vehicles. So let's just see.
Look, we do hear that Prince George will play a starring role this weekend. We saw those lovely photos of Princess Charlotte earlier this week for her birthday. No word on Louis yet because of his bad behaviour before. So what's George going to do?
George is going to be a page of honour, which is really quite an important role. I think we should expect all three children to be quite prominent in this weekend of commemorations and celebrations, not least because we all loved seeing them, didn't we, when they were there for the Platinum Jubilee. And I would include Louis in that. That's my hunch. I just think, OK, he's turned five now. We saw recently some photographs of him. Who can believe, by the way, he's five? He seemed to be about 4 days old 5 minutes ago. Yeah. But I think they'll all be front and centre, not just for the coronation service, which will probably be the reserve of the older two. Louis might not make that. It's going to be probably 2 hours long, but expect them at the coronation concert too.
Okay, what about Uncle Harry? What do we know about his plans? Is it going to be a fly-in, fly-out kind of scenario?
Uncle Harold, as we now know him from his spare, we think he's flying in on Friday. We don't quite know how. Will it be a private jet or a commercial flight? Wait to be seen. But there's all this talk, Sylvia, as you know, of him making a very whistle-stop visit. It's been dubbed Harry in a Hurry. Operation Harry in a Hurry. So is he going to be staying for the photograph, for the private lunch after that balcony and appearance and flypast? Time will tell. But royal sources are telling me that, look, they're not expecting him to stick around for long.
Is he invited to the private lunch?
Well, I would imagine he would be because it's a family affair. Right. And equally, there's a question mark over whether he's going to appear in the official coronation photographs or is he rushing back so quickly? There's this sense that he wants to be with Archie because it's his fourth birthday. Mm. So he's going to do this kind of transatlantic mad dash to the coronation and back again in time to perhaps tuck the little boy into bed. But I think it's asking a lot of him and people are hoping there'll be some kind of royal rapprochement. So just have to wait and see what the chemistry looks like on the day.
Oh, I have a feeling it's going to be on the icier side. thank you, Camilla. We'll chat
soon. Camilla.